Welcome to the Cunningham Piano Show, where we explore life between the keys. I'm your host, Hugh Sung, and I have a very special guest in this episode. I have Susan Marcel. Not only are you here to share some beautiful music, but a beautiful life story as well. Susan, welcome to the show.
Thanks, Hugh.
So wonderful to have you here.
Thank you.
So let's begin by what you do. What is your day job?
Well, I'm a full-time psychiatrist in private practice in Philadelphia, and I do that full-time. I very much enjoy it, helping people. I got into medicine and didn't think I would end up in psychiatry, but I did. I found that I really loved listening to people and helping them be happier, find more satisfaction in their life.
It's interesting that you say that. We were talking a bit before we started the shoot. The whole aspect of listening was...
Right.
Quite a challenge for you from what you explained from your childhood.
Yeah, when I grew up in a pretty loud family where everybody talked and nobody listened. So I learned to listen. I became the listener of the family in a way and the perceiver. And now I listen for a living.
It's interesting that you were, one of the things that you said to me as we were getting to know each other that really struck me is that my piano is my life. And along the lines of you becoming the listener in a very loud family. Your music, your piano was such an integral part of that healing. You mind sharing a little bit about that?
Well, I my mom bought me a little piano when I was 3 years old, and I just played on it, and she signed me up for lessons, and I never stopped. I fell in love, truly fell in love with the sound of the piano. It helps me in so many ways. It's like breathing. You know, I don't go a day without playing. And, you know, I had some rough times growing up through my childhood. And the music and the piano was always a place of comfort, of solace. I could express my emotions through it. When no one was listening, the piano was always there. And I could listen to myself. Maybe they would hear it, maybe they wouldn't, but it was truly a an emotionally healing experience.
We were talking a bit about the aspect of therapy. You are a healer. And I was asking, well, I'm just going to go ahead and ask the question, what is therapy? And you had a really fascinating answer.
Sure, yeah. Therapy is a conversation between two people, where a therapist helps a person who's struggling, basically, you know, with their emotions, with their thoughts, with their, you know, how their body's feeling. And the type of therapy that I do integrates all of that. And some of my patients actually have used music to heal, and we've tapped into that. And my love for piano has helped me help my patients better.
And I also sense that there's a powerful medicine, as it were, when you have the means or the outlet to express yourself on the piano as you do. And I'm so moved at how you are making those connections in terms of the power of listening, the power of being heard, and also transforming that to a healing experience for your patients.
My patients. I have a piano in my one office, and just by chance I was storing it in there one day, and one of my patients asked if they could play it, and I got it out. It's a little electric piano, and he started just playing with it, and he was a very introverted individual, and he enjoyed, I saw a little bit of him get excited, you know, he expanded because he was very frightened. He had some early childhood problems and trauma, and the piano looked like it cracked through something, the ice. So music is therapy. You know, music touches us. We can say things through music that we can't say in words. It's deeper. I mean, all of us, no matter what language we speak, you know, a tone, a certain sound affects our body, affects our mind, our heart. So
I think that's one thing that is so needed, especially in today's cacophonous world,
it's a very noisy
especially
world.
As we're digitally disconnected.
Sure.
We have our devices and texts and electronic communications, and even though there's a lot of communication, mm-hmm. it's very easy to feel like nobody's listening to us.
Sure, the digital age, we're connected, but we're not really making contact. Mm-hmm. You know, we can't really feel each other, see each other. There's a barrier between us. So, you know, music for me has been a way to heal me personally, but also to help my patients and just to have fun. I mean, who doesn't have fun listening to a great song on the radio?
And that's another thing I really wanted to applaud you for, that there's a difference between music that you just simply listen to passively
and being active.
Mm-hmm.
Not creating it, not being professional,
but just it's in your life. It's you.
The one song that I played for the show was a song that came out of my mom passed away about a year and a half ago, and in the sadness of that, she died with dementia, and I just sat down one day and started playing, and this song came out of me, and I felt sad. But I also felt some relief and some joy, and something moved, something changed in me. Mm. And it's been delightful to think that, you know, that's music can help me in that way.
I'd like us to start with your song or your mother's song. One of the most interesting aspects of the show is the fact that we invite our guests to choose from a variety of pianos for their episodes, and you've kind of taken advantage of that. Most people choose only one, but you've taken advantage of the fact that you could have more than one. So you've actually chosen this Schimmel, this German-made Schimmel 185. Yeah. Why did you choose this piano for this song?
It is a much softer, gentler instrument, and the song requires that. You know, a brighter instrument, it wouldn't sound as well.
It's a reflection of your mother's character, isn't it?
Yeah,
you were saying that she's very soft.
She was soft, very warm, and she'd love it if she could hear it.
let's pay homage to your mother. Let's hear you play this. Mm-hmm. Susan, that was, to say it was beautiful is almost too trite. It wasn't just beautiful. There was, how shall I say this? There were places you were playing. I never met your mother. It almost sounded like I could hear her whispering mm-hmm. through this song.
Yeah, there is a whispering quality to it.
And it just, it was painful and yet beautiful at the same time.
Right.
And you composed this yourself. Can you describe how this piece came together? So beautiful, so haunting, and just perfectly describes what I imagine your mother must be.
Well, it's interesting. Some of the chords in the song are actually from an arrangement that my daughter is a vocalist, and I accompany her sometimes when she sings at various things, or we just have some fun at home. And one of the songs that she has recently sung within the past 2-3 years had some of those chords in it, and we just fell in love with it. So those chords were in me, the music and the arrangement. And then I found that once my mom passed, it connected with something deeper in me to be able to play, you know, the chord arrangement and then to improvise on it. Every time I sit down and play, it's a different version of it. As all musicians, we play with, depends on who we are. You know, we come back to the instrument, we're a different person each time we sit down. And so the song grew out of several chords and then it just evolved. Mm. And I don't know that I can even say much more than that, but, you know, that's how art is. Art just happens. It's spontaneous. And that's how I knew it was healing for me, because I wasn't trying. You know, we can play piano and be very technical,
yeah,
and very rigid in the way it's supposed to sound. This is, it's a different feel and a different evolution, different way of expressing emotion.
Well, thank you. Thank you so much for sharing something so personal.
Mm-hmm.
Now, you have one more song, and this is where you're taking advantage of the fact that we have lots of pianos here.
No, you let me.
I'm delighted. So we're going to switch over to the Bösendorfer 200, another magnificent, a very different instrument. Tell us why you chose that to play your next song.
Sure. Well, the song I picked is Yiruma, River Flows Through You, and it is a brighter song. It's much faster. It requires a lot more action. There's a lot of 16th notes in it, so technically, it's a little more challenging, and you need a brighter piano. The Schimmel is very soft.
It's very intimate.
Yes. Mm-hmm. Whereas the other piece, the Yiruma's piece, it needed a little bit more energy and brightness. So when I sat down at the Bösendorfer, I felt something. I felt, yes, this is the right one to play.
Let's hear you play some Yiruma on the Bösendorfer 200.
Okay. Okay. Thank you.
Susan, you've brought out two very different personalities and two different pianos. I can see why you're a master psychiatrist. I can see you know how to draw different characters out. And each piano, in a sense, is like a different person.
Yes.
And you really resonated with wanting to explore those differences. Mm-hmm. I really appreciate that.
Yeah, well, thank you.
Beautiful performance. Mm-hmm. So as we close, Susan, I want you to maybe just share with us how anybody, now you've been playing all your life, mm-hmm. but for, and this is a show that my hope and desire is that this will be for anyone mm-hmm. and to inspire everyone mm-hmm. to play the piano, mm-hmm. to have the experience. Can you share a little bit about why this would be a good idea? Not just, and people think that they have to have talent
to have music
in their life.
No.
Tell me why this could be such a necessary part of everyone's life.
Well, what I said to you earlier, to me, playing piano is like breathing. Yeah. It can feel very natural if you let it.
Mm, as opposed to being worried about the correctness.
The correctness, yeah. Right, which is some of the way people are taught piano. It actually inhibits spontaneity or interpretation of how a piece the original composer might have intended it to be. Well, maybe there's another way of looking at it. And that kind of spontaneity is what I love about playing the piano, that you can bring yourself to it. And that's true of everyone. We all need an outlet. We all need a way to express ourselves. And music is so easy. Everybody can hum. Mm. You can make yourself feel happy just by humming or whistling. Mm. So piano's the next step up for me.
Well, Susan, thank you so much spending time with us.
I really enjoyed talking with you and playing these lovely instruments.
I enjoyed listening to you.
Thank you, thank you.
I know you spent all day listening to other people.
I do.
Thank you for giving me an opportunity to listen to you.
I appreciate it. Thank you.
Well, I hope you enjoyed spending time with us. Be sure to subscribe so that you can get informed whenever we have new episodes. For the Cunningham Piano Show, I'm Hugh Sung. Thank you for watching, and see you next time.